What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be talking about time manipulation effects that are seen in this new Kid Laroi Justin Bieber Stay music video that's number two trending for music right now. So there's two main things that happens throughout this video. We're going to quickly break that down and then hop into Adobe Premiere, After Effects, and even some 3D softwares to show you different ways where you can recreate it yourself. So before we get started here, if you guys are new, consider subscribing. Leave a like if you guys do enjoy this video. It helps me a huge amount with the YouTube algorithm. And comment below if there's anything you'd like to see a tutorial on next. So let me show you the two main time manipulation parts in this video that we're going to be breaking down and showing you guys step by step. The first is slowing down time, and the second is speeding up time. So for the slowing down time, you can see that there's a lot of these 3D elements here tracked into your scene where you have moments frozen, just like this. So we're gonna show you how to track your scenes, how to composite in 3D or 2D elements, and recreate something very similar to this. It's very easy to do this within After Effects, and we're even going to take it one step further, and I'm going to show you some different 3D simulations. So we'll have a little bit of beginner stuff in there and a little bit of advanced stuff in there. So this here, we're not going to count this where he's kind of hanging there. It's probably just him suspended from a cable. Common Hollywood technique in a larger budget video. I'm guessing the majority of you guys aren't working with larger budgets, so a lot of you probably aren't gonna recreate something like that. So we'll skip that and we'll talk about some of the things that are a lot easier to recreate. This one's really cool where you have this frozen coffee cup that you'll see there. Looks really nice. You have this 3D simulation tracked on there. So enough of the frozen time. I think you guys get the idea. Let's move along to the sped up time. So you see the sped up time effect at the end here where they're in this sort of station, and you can see all of these sort of time-lapse looking motion blur people walking around them in the background. So I'm going to quickly explain to you how you can do this, and then I'm going to show you how I shot it and recreated something like this within Adobe Premiere. So a quick brief explanation before the step-by-step. You take two shots. The first shot is your time-lapse in the background of everyone walking around. If you pay attention to the clock there, you can even see how long their time-lapse was. They got a really long shot of that. Now your second shot is your performance shot, and that's where you have nobody in the background and you just have Justin Bieber, Kid Laroi, whoever you're working with, perform in the foreground. Once you have those two shots, you bring them together in your editing software and you do some masking to combine them together. So we're gonna show you how to do something like that. I'll show you how I shot it. We're gonna be using a tripod. In Hollywood, they also have motion control rigs so that they can have the same motion on multiple shots, but that's a whole different story. We're gonna take it easy, use a tripod, and we can add in our own handheld motion after. So let's go into Adobe Premiere, show you how to do the sped up time effect, and then we'll go into After Effects and show you how to do our frozen time effects. So your first shot you want to have as your performance shot. My performance shot is just me sitting here. It's gonna make it a lot easier to mask. And then this is my motion blur shot, which is me walking around through the back of the scene a bunch. So for your motion blur shot, there's some specific rules that you want to take here. You want to shoot with as much motion blur as you possibly can. Camera has a time-lapse setting. You may be able to also do that with a slow shutter speed. Keep that in mind, slow shutter speed, so that you have as much possible motion blur as you can. So for the camera that I shot this with, the shutter speed does not go that low, so I'm not gonna have these crazy long trails. I just have a little bit of minimal motion blur going on here. Then I'm gonna show you some workaround effects that you can apply to add a lot more blurring into this. So let's start to set it up and combine these shots. You want to take the performance shot and place it above your background shot here. So for me, since I'm sitting still, it's gonna be very easy to use Premiere masking just to cut around myself. If your subject is moving a lot in these scenes, then I recommend you look up rotoscoping. Go over to your effect controls in the opacity tab here. You want to grab your masking tool, and I'm just going to click, and you can click the squiggly key on your keyboard to make that full screen to make it a bit easier. And I'm just going to draw a mask around me sitting here. All right, so I've created my mask. If I hide my bottom layer, this is what I have. So me just sitting there, masked out. You guys can mess around with your mask settings by adding any bit of feather. So let's turn back on the visibility of our bottom clip. You're able to see here, since we shot this on a tripod, we've already successfully mixed these two scenes together. So I'm gonna be walking around here in the background, and my foreground is still going to be staying in the front. That's how easy it is to combine these shots. So again, depending on your camera, if you already have a proper motion blur time lapse, this scene should already be done. If you do want to add any more motion blur to your scene, if you have something that looks like mine, where the motion blur just isn't that apparent, I'm gonna show you a quick After Effects trick to add some more blur. So I'm gonna hold down Alt on my keyboard and just click and drag up on my background scene. I'm going to right click on that duplication and I'm going to select replace with After Effects composition to bring that into Adobe After Effects. So not only does After Effects have this motion blur trick, but it's also a lot easier to mask within After Effects. So if you want to do this all within AE, again, you have the access to rotoscoping. I do recommend it, but if you're trying to do something quick, Premiere is always great for that. So to add some more motion blur into this, we're gonna go to our effects and presets on the right, and we're gonna search for the word pixel motion blur. Just go ahead and drag that onto your clip. And this is going to try and process some motion blur here. So you see, if I just toggle that on and off, how much blur we're adding on there. You can also take your shutter angle and crank that up if you want this to be super blurry. So we'll put that to 360 and see what that looks like. You see, if I keep bumping that up, you have a little bit of distortion here. So try not to go overboard, or you may kind of crunch the frames a little bit. You guys can also mess with the shutter samples, but that will increase your render time and your vector detail. So it's really up to you. So that's a quick option for just adding some more motion blur. If you want to have that longer trail without shooting a time lapse, you guys can slap on an echo effect. You can also do that within Adobe Premiere. If you just want to skip the motion blur, drop on an echo, put that on minimum. You guys can see how we have these duplications going on here. If you add the echo with the motion blur, I think it looks a little bit better. And now you can see how we have that sort of trail going on. So that's artificial recreated with effects. In my opinion, the best way is just to shoot a longer time lapse or shoot with that slow shutter speed. But with the effects, I still think this is a pretty good result. So that sums up our sped up time blending effect. Now let me show you how we can freeze time like in that music video. So we're gonna talk about the easy way, which is using After Effects 3D tracking plus some 2D assets, which you can find all over the internet. So I'm going to right click on my footage and I'm going to click replace with After Effects composition to get started. I'm going to right click on this footage. I'm gonna go to track and stabilize. You see how this is grayed out? That's because it's in a composition. So let's double click into here, shorten that at 7 seconds, right click, track and stabilize, and we wanna click track camera. So now After Effects is going to track our scene. Once that's finished tracking, we can bring in any 2D assets and freeze them into any part of our scene that we'd like. All right guys, so once your track is finished, if your track didn't work, make sure your composition size under comp settings is the same width and height as your original footage. In your effect controls, just select your 3D camera tracker to see all of our tracking data. And you can see this is a pretty nice scene. We have a lot of different tracking points, so it should be pretty easy to track in some stuff. You just want to find a point in this scene with this bullseye, and you want to right click and click create solid and camera. So the position of the solid is going to be a good reference for putting different things in the scene. If you maybe want to put something in the foreground, select your 3D camera tracker again. You can make a second bullseye. And again, these are just gonna be references for where you want to put things in your scene. But now that we have our track references, I'm just going to click S on these layers, scale them up a bit. We want to place in any sort of asset at this reference point. So this is actually extremely easy. This is how I added the blood in this scene here that I posted on my Instagram whenever I was working on that Eminem Juice WRLD Godzilla music video tutorial. All you need to do is find some sort of 2D asset that you'd like to track in. I like using Footage Crate. They have a bunch of free assets. This is 100% unsponsored. But again, if you just look up green screen this, green screen that, blood, smoke, glass, whatever it is you're trying to put in, you'll be able to find something. I'll just look up blood, like in my example, and I'll download a couple of these. Bring in some of these blood splats just to show you what I mean by freezing them in our scene. So we'll drag in this one here. So now that we have an asset, we need to match it to our track references here. So what you wanna do is click toggle switches and modes until you can see this 3D layer switch here for your asset. Go ahead and turn that on. Now you'll see this will be tracked in your scene, but it's going to be in a random spot in our scene. So find wherever you want to put this in your scene, and this is where you can use your track references. So do I want to put in the foreground, in the middle, in the background? Let's say in the middle here. So for this track solid, I'm going to go ahead and just grab this little pick whip tool for my blood explosion layer and just drag that pick whip tool onto the track solid. Once I've done that, you can see it's now parented. You want to now open up the asset that you just linked, go to transform, and go ahead and click reset. This will place the positioning exactly on the track reference. And you can now take your scale and just bump that up until you see it. Now you'll see how it's tracked perfectly at the exact point of our reference. You don't want all these squares in your scenes, just hide the visibility of them for now. And that actually tracked perfectly onto the table, which is pretty cool. So we'll play that. So super easy to do something just like that. Now these clips have their own animation and you can leave it like that if you want the motion. But if you do want that frozen time effect, what you guys want to do is apply a freeze frame onto this. So find a part in this animation that you'd like to freeze in time. Once you've found that point, right click on the footage, go over to time, and you want to click freeze frame. So now it's going to be frozen in time and you'll see it's still 3D tracked. So as I play through the scene here, it's going to be perfectly frozen on our table just like that. So extremely easy, super cool trick that you guys can do just using some free assets that you find on the internet. What I want to focus on for the end of this tutorial is making your own simulations in 3D. So we're going to take a little bit of an advanced step. I'm going to use After Effects and C4D to do this, as well as a plugin called RealFlow to create some liquid simulations. Now, if you guys don't have C4D, if you don't have RealFlow, you could also replace that with Blender, which is free. That has a lot of fluid simulations, or whatever other 3D software you're comfortable with that can create a fluid simulation. So this is an example just to show you how you could bring 3D into your After Effects workflow to create your own assets instead of having to always rely on what you find out there on the internet. I'm going to use this scene here where we just have a coffee cup. It'll be very easy to track using the same method we use for the 2D assets. Only difference is we're going to bring that track camera into a 3D software. I'm going to alt click and drag up to make a quick duplication. And then on this duplication, I'm going to right click and again click replace with After Effects composition. Let's double click into our composition here in After Effects. And this is a bit of a long clip, so we only need maybe that much of it. I'll just drag this clip so that it's around 5 seconds. And now I'm going to go ahead and right click on my footage and again click track and stabilize, and I'm going to select track camera. So we'll let After Effects do that. We'll create our reference points, and then we're going to go into Cinema 4D and create some simulated liquid. All right, guys, so once your track is completed, again, if you want to see that in your effect controls, select the 3D camera tracker. You'll see all of our track points. So this is looking good. So I'm going to position my bullseye just like this, where we have it front facing. I'm going to right click and click create solid and camera. So again, you can go through and test your track. So this is going to be the reference for where our mug is in the scene. And this is where we differ from the 2D version. We're going to go up to file. We're going to go to export, and we're going to go to Maxon Cinema 4D exporter. So this is going to save this scene as a C4D file. So we'll name this tutorial. Here it is, tutorial C4D project file. And we can just double click to open that within C4D. So this is why I love C4D for that After Effects 3D workflow, because you can just bring those project files straight in. So if we open up this little null that we have here in our objects, you're gonna see we have the 3D camera tracker and the exact track solid that we just created within After Effects. So if I click this button to pop off my camera, and I zoom out a bit, to here's my camera, here's my track solid where my mug would be. And if I press play, you can see the exact camera movement that I did in that scene recreated in 3D. So using this 3D camera track, we're able to easily place 3D objects in here and even simulations. So let's create a liquid simulation of some coffee coming out of the cup. To do that, I'm going to use RealFlow. This is a paid plugin. Whenever you're creating simulations, you're most likely going to have to pay for some sort of tool which allows you to do that. So I'll click RealFlow. I'm going to click scene just to put that in there. And I'll go ahead and just move this RealFlow scene over in the direction of my reference point. So once I've done that, I'm going to go up to RealFlow again, and we're just going to go to emitters, and I'll create a circle emitter. If I go to the beginning and press play, you'll see how these sort of rain down these little particles. I'm going to grab my emitter, and I'm just going to rotate that sideways. So I'll grab my rotation tool, kind of point that up, and then I'm going to shrink down this emitter size a tiny bit. So let's click play again. So you see how it's shooting sideways. Now let's add some different variables into this. So I'm going to go up to RealFlow. I'm going to go to either Daemons or Demons. I don't know how it's exactly pronounced, but we'll add in some gravity. So now when I click play, you'll see how this flows downward. So starting to get more towards what we want. Demons again, and we're going to add in this sheeter demon. This is going to make it so there's not as many gaps within the particles. It kind of makes it a little bit more flowy, in my opinion. Another cool thing you can do is you can put different 3D geometry here to alter the path of these particles. So if you really wanted to, you could go in, recreate a mug just like in this scene in 3D by modeling something like that, and you can have it literally emitting out of the mug. Now, a quick workaround for that, if you don't want to fully recreate all the geometry in the scene, we can go up to our objects and create something like a tube. And what we want to do is we want to make it so the particles are reacting with this geometry. So we'll click play. You see how it's just going right through? What we want to do is right click on this tube. We want to go to real flow tags and add a collider. And again, even if you're using Blender or something else, the main concept usually stays the same, where you can, where you're emitting particles with something, you're adding colliders to different geometry. And now with that collider tag, you're going to see how this bounces off here, and we're creating a whole different sort of simulation. So you can move this around and just kind of experiment here. All right, guys, so once you've found a simulation look that you like, I'm gonna show you guys a couple tricks for putting this all together. So first off, to go up to Real Flow and just click Mesher. Now, if you press play, you're gonna see that mesher over there in the distance. For some reason, mine doesn't like line up, so I'm just going to grab that and pull it closer. Make sure everything is looking the way that you guys want. You guys can select the mesher up here on the right. You can change any of this, such as radius, smoothing. So because this is actually an animation, if you see, if I press play, you can see how that's flowing down. Remember that we want to have this frozen in time. So I'm gonna show you a little trick that you can do. So what you wanna do is find a place where everything looks okay. So I think this is fine. You want to click on fluid here. What you guys wanna do is use this initial state button. So we're gonna click use initial state, and then we're gonna click create initial state at the exact moment where you want this to be frozen. Now, if you go to the very beginning of the timeline, instead of starting from nothing and then flowing into this, it's going to start from this initial state and then keep animating. So to stop the animation, all you need to do is over here, this fluid section, just go ahead and check that off. And now if you press play, you're gonna see this is just frozen in time. So that's what we want. We'll go back to mesher here, and over here on the right, we're gonna click build mesh. Now we can start to line this up with our actual scene. So the great thing about C4D and After Effects, if I just click file, save here for my C4D scene, we can go back into After Effects, and I can actually just drag back in that exact same C4D project file. So I'll drag in tutorial. Now this isn't lined up because we're not in our camera view in C4D. So make sure whenever you're doing your lining up, you always check on your camera and then file save, and then go back into After Effects, and you're going to see that change happen in just a second. So there you go. So here's what our scene looks like. Everything is tracked properly, and you're able to make those adjustments just by using After Effects and your C4D scene. So, all right, guys, so you can switch between After Effects and C4D just to line everything up. You can turn off all the track solids once you don't need them anymore. They're just kind of in the way. So just turn off the visibility of them so that they're not showing anymore. So once you have everything set up here, all we really need to do is add a coffee material for this, but we need to make our material and then render it out. So I'm going to quickly show you how I create my material. I like using the Octane render engine. It's personal preference, but I'll go ahead and show you how I would make a liquid material using that. So I'm going to go to create shaders, C4D Octane material. And then with this material open, I'm going to change the type from diffuse to specular. And then we can drop that onto our liquid. Let's go to transmission. For the color, I'm gonna make that sort of a lighter coffee color. And then I'm also gonna go to medium. We're gonna add in a scattering medium. And then if we click that open, for our absorption and our scattering, we can just add in an RGB spectrum. So what that's really gonna do is it's just going to make it so that some parts are lighter and some are darker, try and give it more of that coffee feel. And you guys can change the density here to switch up the parts that are lighter and darker. So I think that looks okay. In terms of our render settings, I'm gonna go ahead and click up here. We'll change my renderer to Octane because, again, that's what I'm using to render this. Let's go to our Octane settings. We want to check on alpha channel so that we don't have this white background. I'll also check off keep environment. I think this should all be fine, just base settings. I won't go too deep into it for this. Let's go to camera imager, denoiser, and enable that. We're also going to right click on our 3D camera tracker and go to Octane tags and add an Octane camera tag. We select that. We can go to camera imager and enable that. And that way we'll have that built-in denoising. So this is only around 121 frames. We'll go to our output here and just make it stop at 121. Under save, we'll check on alpha channel. Under octane render, we'll check on use denoise beauty pass. And then we'll go back to save and create a folder to render out our coffee. So I'll create a new folder. I'll name that coffee tut render, and then for the file name, I'll just name that coffee. And that's about it, guys. We can go ahead and render this. It's going to render our liquid simulation following the exact camera movement that we brought in from After Effects. All right, guys, let's go ahead and bring back that render into After Effects and finish this up. So I'm going to right click in my project bin, go to import multiple files, and then I'm going to navigate to that folder where I just saved all those frames from our render. So coffee tut render, select the first frame, tip sequence, and click import, import as footage, and click import. Click OK, and then click done. And then the one thing that they do here for some reason, if I drag this over, you'll see that our footage is 23.976, and in our C4D comp, it imports it as 23.976 as well. But for some reason, whenever you put it back in After Effects, it comes out as 30. So all you need to do is go to that comp that you imported, right click, interpret footage, and then go ahead and assume this frame rate, whatever it is your normal footage was. So mine was 23.976. And then back in our comp, you can just drag that in there. Everything should be already lined up. So you can just press play. You don't have to do any extra tracking, and you'll see how that's hovering in the place that we specified in C4D. So a quick little way to show you guys the power of utilizing 3D in your workflows. So I hope you guys did enjoy this tutorial on manipulating time using After Effects and even using a 3D software so that you don't have to rely on pre-built assets. If you guys did enjoy, slap a like on the video. It helps a huge amount. And as always, guys, thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for supporting. And I'll see you guys in the next one.